Well, flying cars caught the attention of everyone at CES, the tech industry's most watched event of the year that wrapped up last week. But it was also jam-packed with other wildly futuristic gadgets that include some very cool robots and smarter-than-ever devices. Hmm.
The future looks convenient, that's for sure. Joining us now with some of his picks from CES is Shelly Palmer, professor of advanced media in residence, Syracuse University Newhouse School. Shelly, thank you so much for joining us.
Nice to be here. How are you guys doing?
We're doing pretty well. So let's start off with the flying car. That really grabbed everyone's attention. Yeah. Because how realistic is that really when we have videos of Waymo drivers, non-drivers, just going in circles? So if we can't figure it out on the ground, how realistic is it that we have these futuristic flying cars?
I think they are farther in the future than anyone would have you believe. First of all, we don't need them. We already have three-dimensional travel. They're called overpasses and underpasses. So I'm not sure the traffic jams are going to be avoided anytime soon with flying cars. But what's great about these drones is that they're single and double person. They're great for medical emergency evacuations. A lot of first responders are trying to incorporate these into their fleets of ambulances and rescue vehicles. So I don't know for personal use if you're going to be getting around town in a multi-propeller drone, but you certainly are going to start to see these used for rescue operations all over the place.
Wait, Shelly, can we technically call this a flying car? Because to me, that was
a flying trunk.
Yeah, that came from the trunk. So like that was not actually part of the car.
They call that that's the land aircraft carrier. It's basically an SUV with a single-person drone stuffed in the back. And the idea would be you drive out to close to the area where you need to deploy it, and then you would deploy it. So it's good for first responders. Not so good for, you got to get back to your car.
Mm-hmm. So. You know, robots are always popular at the convention. So talk to us about this multitasking one.
So the SwitchBot is a new concept, this idea of being able to have a platform that you add things to. So you can add arms, you can add soda dispensers, you could add a table, you could add an air purifier, you could add pretty much anything you want to it. The goal here is to make it as flexible as it could possibly be inside your home. Now, the big question, do you really need a rolling Roomba with a serving tray on top of it? It reminds me of R2-D2, on Jabba's pleasure barge. I'm not sure that it's, a real job for a robot, but that doesn't mean they're not going to show off the concept at CES. Mm-hmm.
Sure. What about some stuff like Cuddly robots, some cute ones? We're looking
so
at ones like
So this is fascinating. What we learned at CES is that Asian children will cozy up to plastic robots, but Western children, American children will not. And so they've made a whole bunch of plush, fuzzy robots. One of the ones that I liked was Tombot Genie. It's a little dog, basically a robot dog. If you get too close to it and it starts to move like a dog, it kind of makes you feel weird. But
it's a little creepy.
Because you can have like an actual dog, But this one doesn't, do
poo,
anything that
poop, pee.
Yeah.
I wasn't going to say any of those things, but yes, all those things, it doesn't do any of that. It just takes batteries.
Kind of nice, I guess.
Yeah. Is this weird? Is it like warm? Does it mimic like a warm body or something like that?
Look, in all seriousness, we have a very serious loneliness epidemic going on around the world right now. People are starting to talk to synthetic companions, and there is a monstrous business, at least if we believe what we saw at CES, in robotic companions, which takes this idea of a synthetic companion to the next level. Mm. Not only can you talk to it, but of course you can see it, and it has agency as it rolls around the house or sits in your lap. Yeah. So is this a business?
It reminds me of a Furby.
I was going to say, the one that we're looking at right now, the Marumi, looks like a dust bunny.
Yeah.
Kind of, yeah. I mean, look, there's lots of different robots. TCL had one that honestly looked like Chucky, and it was coming for me.
loneliness.
Yeah. But look, I had one favorite thing at the show I'll tell you about. It was by Kieran. It was the salty spoon. It's an electric spoon that makes your bland food taste salty. And I got to tell you, I tried it in the super secret handshake room because the idea of the communal spoon didn't work for me. It actually works. I was really surprised. It shocks your tongue a little bit. You got to get used to it. But once you're under, it works.
Wait, what's a super secret handshake room?
Well, they have meeting rooms that they'll take you to if you're analysts like I am, okay, or you're in the business, and they will show it to you. You can use your, it's a quieter environment. That's the super secret handshake room, as opposed to standing on the convention floor and saying, would you like to taste it? It's like, no, thanks.
Very really, interesting.
No. They need a hot sauce one for you.
There we go. I'll take it. Less sodium in my diet.
Yeah.
Absolutely right.
Shelly, we appreciate talking to you.
Thank you.
It's always great to see you guys.